Hello to you students. Today we are going to start chapter 17, that is circles. Before starting the chapter, I am going to explain you some important definitions which are related to this chapter. So let's start it. Our first definition is of circle. A circle is a set of points which moves in a plane in such a way that its distance from a fixed point is always constant. Circle is a set of points and it is move in a plane and its distance from a fixed point. Here fixed point is point O. Its distance from a fixed point is always constant. That means each point which is lying on the circle having same distance from its fixed point. That means here P and R and Q, they all having same distance from point O. That constant distance is called radius and the fixed point is called the center of the circle. Constant distance is called radius. Here that OP, the distance of P from O and distance of R from O, distance of Q from O is called the radius of the circle. So here OP, OR and OQ, these are the radius of the circle and their value is same. Let us suppose if OP is of 2 cm, it means that OR and OQ are also of 2 cm and the fixed point is called the center of the circle. That point, O point is called the center of the circle. Next is the center of a circle. The center of a circle is the point which is equidistant from all points on the circumference of the circle. Center of the circle means that point. That point which is equidistant. Equidistant from all the points which are on the circumference of the circle. This is the circumference of the circle, that is the boundary of the circle. And each point which lying on that boundary having same distance from that center. As I explained you in the previous definition, in the definition of circle, that each point which lies on circumference having fixed distance from the center. Next is radius. The radius of a circle is the length of the line segment from the center to any point on its circumference. Radius means it is the length. Length of a line segment. Length of line segment. From the center to any point on its circumference. Here this is a center and A is a point which lying on its circumference. So length of OA is the radius of the circle. Here P is a point which lying on the boundary of the circle and O is the center of the circle. So OP is the radius of the circle. Yes, next is diameter. A diameter is the longest line segment passing through the center whose end points lie on the circle. That means it is the longest line segment which is passing through center. AB is the longest line segment and it is passing through the center and its end point lie on the circle. Its end point lie on the circle. Here they show us as point A and point B. These are the end of this line segment and it is passing through the center of the circle. That is at from which point? That is O point. And diameter is twice the radius. We know that radius means the distance of each point from the center. Here OA and OB. These are the two radius of the circle. And diameter, when we combine both, and it will become a diameter. Diameter is the twice of the radius. So AB is the diameter which passes through the center of the circle. It means that this formula is very important. Diameter is equals to 2 multiply radius. Diameter is equals to 2 multiply radius. When we multiply radius 2 times, twice of the radius is called diameter. Next is circumference. The distance around the edges of the circle is called the circumference of the circle or boundary of the circle. Here in this picture, the boundary of the circle, they show us like this. Okay, so this is the circumference of the circle. That is the only boundary of the circle. Next is chord. A line segment inside a circle whose endpoints lie on the circle is called chord. That means a line segment which is lying inside the circle and whose endpoint lie on the circle. Here P and Q, these are the endpoint of this line segment, so it is called as a chord. Also here A and B, these are the endpoints of this line segment, and this line segment is also called as diameter of the circle. And diameter of a circle is the longest chord in a circle. This line is very important line. Diameter of a circle is the longest chord in a circle. Next is secant. A line which intersects the circle at two different points is called the secant line. Here AB is a line which intersects the circle at two different points. So it is called the secant line. Next is tangent. A line which touches the circle at one point only is called the tangent. Here AB is a line and it touches the circle at only point P. So this is called the tangent of the circle. Next is very important definition, arc of a circle. The arc is a portion of the circumference of a circle. Here AB. AB is showing us an arc. That means this portion of the circle, that means the circumference of a circle, portion of a circumference of a circle is the arc of the circle. Here they show us minor arc and major arc. The shortest arc joining two points on the circumference of a circle is called the minor arc. That means here AB and this portion is called as minor arc because it is the shorter arc and it joining the two points here on the circumference. So it is called the minor arc. On the other hand, larger one, this is the larger one. The remaining portion is the larger one. So it is called the larger arc and it is known as major arc. That means the largest, the remaining portion of the circumference is called as the major arc. Next is semicircle. A semicircle is one half of the whole arc of a circle. That means half of the circle is called as semicircle. Next is sector of a circle. A sector is a part of a circular region enclosed by two radii of the circle and their intersected arc. Here OA and OB, these are the two radius and the portion which is enclosed within these two radius, it is called as the sector. Here they show us the minor, that is the smaller portion. it is called as the minor sector, and the larger one is called the major sector. Next is segments. A chord divides a circle into two parts. These two parts are called the segment. It means that when a chord, here AB is a chord. As we know from the definition of chord, a chord is a line segment inside the circle whose end points are lying on the circle. Here AB is a chord, and when it divides the circle into two parts, then segment will be formed. Here AB divides the circle into two parts, and here the smaller portion is called as minor segment and the larger part is called as major segment. Next is concentric circles. Circles having same center but different radii are called concentric circles. It means that circles which having same center. In this picture, they show us two circles, and both circles having same center, that is at point O, but their radius are different. The smaller circle is having radius R, that is smaller r, whereas the another one having radius R. It is represented as capital R. So it means concentric circles are those circles having same center but different radii.